Singapore is so hot. You can even fry an egg outdoors.
My egg is cooking, I'm so happy.
But there's one thing that sure likes the sun.
Not me, this.
This is Kamal, a senior analyst at Energy Market Authority, which means...
I work with various agencies to better plan the locations of solar panels in Singapore.
Wait, first off, what's the point of solar panels anyway?
Solar panels are a source of clean energy. It also provides electricity to common corridors, HDB lifts, and other areas that need electricity. Solar panels absorb energy from the sun and convert it to electricity that will then be distributed in our grid. But this is not a science class, so I'll spare you the details.
And since Singapore is so sunny, it must be the best place to harvest solar energy?
Although Singapore is a very good place for solar, we do get a lot of clouds as well, and this affects the amount of electricity that can be generated. This is known as solar intermittency. Because of this intermittency, we will still need to rely on conventional power plants. So sometimes when people find out that I'm from EMA, they'll ask me, "Hey, Kamal, what's the best retailer I can choose? Or what's the future price going to be?" But I cannot crystal ball the future, and that is also not my job. My job involves looking at where are the best places to deploy solar and to work with other government agencies. That's a summarized version. It actually involves a much longer process. There's so little space in Singapore. There's so many different things that we can use the space for. Deploying solar is just one of the many things that can be done with our precious space that we have. Rooftops have a large potential for solar, but there's already a lot of things that you can place on rooftops, like gardens, swimming pools, playgrounds. That's why we have to explore using one space for multiple functions. For example, in NTU, where they have solar panels as well as plants that are growing underneath. So with one location, you have solar panels and you have greenery that is co-located in one space. So besides rooftops, PUB has plans to deploy more solar panels on reservoir spaces. So next time you are jogging or doing water activities, you might just spot some solar panels on the reservoirs.
So can Singapore totally convert to clean energy?
Natural gas will still continue to be a dominant source of fuel in Singapore, but solar is the most promising renewable energy generation. So our energy landscape is continuously evolving. By 2030, we are trying to deploy at least 2 GW-peak of solar. That's enough to power 350,000 households in Singapore. So Singapore may probably be one of the most solar-dense cities in the world. Unlike other countries, Singapore doesn't have the luxury of having large spaces of land to deploy solar. But what we can do is to share our experience how to deploy more solar in a small city like Singapore. Even though Singapore does not have a lot of space, we can still make a difference. To me, that's what's fulfilling. When I help to deploy more solar in Singapore, I'm playing my small part in the fight against climate change.